Welcome back to our Introduction to Capella course. In this section of the course, we're going to talk about how we take the physical architecture and we ensure that it delivers the system's capability that we've been walking through all the way from the operational analysis, the system analysis, and to the logical architecture. So we're going to continue that now in the physical architecture. In this phase, we're going to look at this capability. Again, you can see that this capability is a sub-capability of developing the physical architecture. And we are going to, and it's primarily done by the system architect, but with the involvement of domain engineers and manufacturing and marketing engineers, service people, that all are involved when we get down to this level of detail. In this phase, we're going to focus on a couple steps that we're going to be looking at, and those steps are focused on this red flow that goes through here. The transitioning has already taken place, but it's still part of this flow of the functional chains from the logical. We're going to basically then ensure that the system capability is delivered by the physical architecture. And then later in the section, we're going to do an optional section on ensuring the logical scenarios, enriching logical scenarios, and kind of introducing this topic of a logical scenario, especially since we're focused on a software-oriented product, and we'll do that in a separate video. So what we're doing in this phase is we're continuing this connection that we started with logical architecture and system analysis of making sure that the capabilities get addressed as they move from left to right. And this is done in this phase by looking at the physical functional chains, provide location and status location that are developed from the functional chains in the logical architecture. Again, we're going to focus on this step right here. And now we're going to walk through the steps of that. So we'll transition over video and we'll go through the steps, basically transition over to the actual tool and we'll go through the steps involved. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to open up the physical architecture that we worked on previously. And that's this one here. So this one has all the functions on it that have been brought over, and we have them laid out on this diagram. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to bring over the functional chains that have been transitioned. And we did this in an earlier session that we already transitioned them. The ability to transition is just to sit on the functional chain in the logical architecture and use that right mouse button to transition. So I'm going to scroll down here and I see functional chains. I'm going to look at those and I'll see that I have both two functional chains, provide status and provide location. I'm going to basically bring both of those over onto this diagram. And it only allows you to bring on the functional chains that have some functions that they participate in the diagram. So that's why there was only two of them, or only three presented. Those are the three that basically have some functions that are part of the scenario. So now the first one we're going to look at, you notice we have a red flow and a blue one. We got those right up here. I can kind of show which ones are which. So we have provide location. And it's noticed that it is indicating that it's invalid. So that means it needs to have some modifications to it to make it valid. And we also have provide status, which was also invalid. So, and the reason why they're invalid is because there's not a flow from one to the other. There may be multiple reasons. And when we open them up, you'll actually see how I can fix some of those invalid states. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up the provide location one first. And we're going to open up the functional change description. And notice they are disconnected. The functional chain has a number of green functions, but they aren't connected together. And that's typical of what you'll see. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to split the screen and bring it down to this view here. And we'll start from right from the beginning. So here's provide location. So if I bring these flows up here and kind of get them all together, that provide location is this one. It's an actor. So I can see that it's blue because it is an actor function. So that's pretty typical of the way it always will look. And then I see that that's going to this function here called compute location. Now compute location goes over to this object over here called gather location. So I'll look and see if I have gather location. And sure enough, I have gather locations of chargers. And I actually have two of them. So that means I need probably get rid of one, or in this case, it might be just easier to get rid of both of them, and I'll show you why. I'll get rid of both of these. And I'm going to go down here to compute locations, and I'm just going to use this command here, function exchange and functions, and then what it'll do is it'll basically give me the functional exchange that goes between the two of them. So here I have the functional exchange, and I just do it that easily. I can add that functional exchange that went between those two functions. I can add it to this one. And likewise, now I can go from here, and I'll do the same step. Gather location of functions, and that's going to then go to relay locations, which is up here. So I've got the relocations in the cloud. And then finally, there's this last function. And I'll repeat the same step. And I'll get rid of this relay locations there because we're not going to need it. And then I see I have provide locations and receive location. It's kind of the last step, and it is looking like that's the right one. So just do it a little differently this time. I'm going to bring this provide locations over here. And instead of using this exchange end function, I'll just use exchange. And I'll go from relay. Just go right from here, from relay to provide location. And it comes up with the option that I have. And sure enough, that creates that link. So there's the link between. I'm just going to go here and I'm going to relay out the diagram real quick. Do a relay. Layout all. And notice now that I have that done, I've created all those connections, the invalid goes away. So now I have a valid functional chain that connects all the steps for that provide location. And that's what we want. So now I'm just going to repeat that same process that I just did. Move these things around a little bit, make this a little prettier. Okay, so that's open. And I'm going to close that one out. And now I'm going to go provide status. I'm going to open it up the same way. Functional provide status. Again, same type of thing. They're not all connected. I'm going to split the screen with it. And we'll start with, let's see what the input would be. In this case, the input is actually coming from this gather performance information, which does have a connection to it. But we're going to start with that one. It has a connection a little bit further. It comes from the original thing called gather performance location. Its input is coming from the send telemetry data. So basically start with that one, gather performance information. Oh, here's send telemetry data. So I have it. So I'll leave that connected for now. And then this says gather performance information, goes to here, goes send status to charger. Oh, we want to go to this gather all charger statuses. That's not on here. So let's just get rid of this one since we already have that on there once. We'll keep the display statuses because I think we'll need that. And I'm going to just go add the one that we don't have. There we go, gather all charger statuses. There it is. So now I've got that. Now that's going to be connected to relay charger statuses. And again, that's not showing, so I'm just going to use this view here. Relay charger statuses, which goes to that view. And then that goes over to display statuses, that flow right there. So let's just use the exchange one. And we got that. So now that functional chain is complete. And sure enough, you'll see the status has changed. Now that's a complete functional chain. It goes from one to the other. So that basically shows how the functional chains then are made, going from one, from basically the inputs to them all the way to the output. And it shows now the functions are being delivered that satisfies this capability. So we'll see that we have that here. And so that kind of concludes this section of it. We can look at the functional chain in a little more detail. So if I sit on the provide status functional chain here, you'll see all the memberships of it. You'll see that it actually says that it is connected to a capability called provide status. That's actually a physical capability. And you'll see here's the provide status, which is the logical. If I go this, you can see that provide status is the logical version of that functional chain. So I basically have made the functional chain that was logical. Now it's being it's been realized into the physical space across all these various components that we've put on here. Okay. That kind of wraps up this section. Thank you for listening.